guys, here we go, 20.4, nearly to the end of this open. Okay, we've got another good workout, long duration, 20 minutes. Okay, we start with 30 box jumps, 15 clean and jerks, 30 box jumps, 15 clean and jerks, 30 box jumps, 10 clean and jerks, and then we move into the single leg squats, where for most of us, probably the workout would be done around there, as the weights do clearly get quite heavy. So a couple of aspects to look at this. You are allowed to step up on the box jumps, which I would highly advise. You've got a lot of time to get through this workout as much as possible. You're not going to complete it, not being bad in any way, but you know the weights are seriously heavy and there's a lot of single leg squats. So you want to look at this workout, see where you want to get to, and then make it just a barbell workout once you get there. So staying with the step ups is really going to save a lot on that hip extension, which you're really going to need once you get to your heavy bar. If you want to move a bit quicker, then you can jump up. I'd advise stepping down. Don't decide now, I've seen the games athletes do a rebound, I'm going to do a rebound. That takes a little bit of practice and it takes a lot out of you. Remember, it's a faster rate of doing it. Your heart rate's going to go up. We want to try and keep that down quite a bit so you can really focus on your lifting. The weights do go up quite a bit, okay? Most of us are going to probably look for the guys to getting into that 83 kilo bar. Ladies, it's about 50 odd kilos. Take your time. You've got the clock, okay? You only need the tie break once you finish the box jumps. If you're looking for that tie break time, then just move a little bit quicker there. But again, stay with those step ups. Really work well with the clean and jerks. Warm up, you want a good general warm up for this workout. You want to spend a good 10, 15 minutes going between the rower, maybe some kettlebell swings, some burpees, moving around the variations of the body that you're going to use for this. Once you've done that, then a bit more of a dynamic prep, looking at your stiff ranges. Definitely take a look at the ankles on this workout if you're looking to get to those pistols. If not, again, maybe looking at the hips, loosening off the hips with some 90-90s, maybe a little bit of banded work, and then moving into your clean and jerk. I would definitely advise warming up to that weight you know you're going to get to. Have a little practice run with it, maybe one or two reps, so it doesn't shock you when you get there. Once you're in the workout, adrenaline's going to kick in. It will make that weight feel better when you're there, but you want to definitely have tested it before you get there. And just enjoy that 20-minute time cap. So just take that full time, get there, get on that bar and just drill it. Singles most of the way.
What's your strategy?
Definitely box jumps, step downs. Do you want to go on rebounding?
Yeah, I wouldn't rebound unless it's something that you've been doing quite a bit of, otherwise your Achilles will hate you. Plus, time-wise, you won't be saving so much time, I don't think. And don't be afraid to do step-ups.
Yeah, yeah.
What's your biggest fear for the workout?
Death.
I think the main thing is work out, look at the weights of the workout and work out which bar realistically you're going to get to. And then work out your pacing from there. So if you know you're not going to get past the third bar, wherever it may be, then, or you know you're going to have to start squat cleaning at that weight, then try rush the first set, get through it as quickly as possible for your split time, but then you want to start doing singles almost as soon as possible.
But also try and make sure that you don't have any misses as the bar gets heavier, because that will be costly time-wise and mentally, I think.
I think the main thing is the box jumps are going to jack your heart rate up, so you want to try calm it down on the clean and jerks. If you try and go touch and go the whole way through, you're going to gas yourselves out by the second round.
There's plenty of time. This is a barbell workout, isn't it? Really?
Yeah.
You can change to your lifters if that helps you do your pistols. A lot of people are better doing pistols in lifters, and also obviously the weight's heavier on the bar, so that's probably a good strategy. Internally rotate more than you think you should, and if you're like me and you have to hold your alternative, hold the alternating foot, then you just get through it, don't you? You're quite fast at them though, aren't you?
Okay. If the judge no reps you on your left foot, then you've got to redo that rep on the left foot. You can't go to the right and then go back to the left. Judges, or you can have someone change your barbell, but that judge cannot touch your barbell or replace it once you've started the reps. So they can touch the barbell and change the weights while you're on the box, but then they can't touch it mid clean and jerk set. Yeah, yeah.
4, would you recommend it as a useful thing to do on a Friday afternoon?
Yes.
Well, I wasn't doing anything else, so.
Probably the most enjoyable open workout for a while.
You've only done this workout for a while.
Exactly.
I controversially did the scaled.
So controversial.
Because I'm a powerlifter these days, so I don't do CrossFit. But it's a completely different beast.
Yeah, it fries your legs a bit more than you think. Like, I think we both switched to step-ups in the second round of box jumps.
Yeah.
And it just allows your heart rate to come down. It doesn't tire your legs out as much as the jumping each time. So, I mean, for pretty much everyone, I'd recommend step-ups. Or rotate between the two.
Yeah.
Like, as you feel your heart rate come down, then go back to jumping up. If you feel it get away from you, go back to step-ups. Like, there's not too much time lost.
If you're doing the scaled workout, you'll be doing a lot of step-ups. And I would recommend popping that ball onto your shoulder. And that way, at least you'll get nice big open lungs so you can breathe. I think if you hug it, where are you going? If you hug it, then you're just going to shut everything down and make it even harder for yourself.
Yeah. Like the dumbbell last year, putting it up there so you can breathe as opposed to holding it in front.
Good fun workout, though.
That was good fun. It's long, though. It's long.
How did you do on the barbell?
I got to the 124 and peer pressured into having 3 attempts at it. But
I tried to chalk you up. You weren't having any of it.
I didn't want to do that, but I shouldn't have.
Well, I found it really entertaining that I had like all the blue plates on my bar, because it kind of looks like a giant suite. So that was fun.
What I will say is when you're on the barbell, especially at the earlier rounds, if you do drop the bar to rest, stay at the bar. Don't walk away. Don't like walk around. Like when it gets heavier, you tend to go into do that because you want to chalk up and everything. But when the bar's light, stay at the bar.
When you're doing box step ups, make sure that you plant the other foot. Otherwise, you'll get no rep. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because you can move really quickly, but if you don't plant that other foot, then it'll be a waste of a rep.
And the pistols, your legs are pretty fried by then. So definitely power clean.
You've literally got steam coming off of you.
Yeah, definitely power clean the cleans as opposed to squat cleaning if you can.
Power jerk or split jerk?
It depends what you're more comfortable with.
I think split jerk will fry your legs even more though, won't it?
It will, but if the bar's too heavy for you.
Yeah, true.
You don't want to miss lift.
Should we talk about the people that are doing really well?
Yep.
Can you read my writing?
Not really.
We got scaled last week, 20.3. Julie got 703. Smashed it.
Gareth Hodges also did really well.
Gareth Hodges, 23R something. Can't read all that
He's
says.
He's 23rd and...
Oh, 23rd.
But he was lifting well above his weight. So he did really well just to sort of...
Well done, Gareth.
And Tristan told me he even said well done to Martin Sands, which is like unheard of. So he must have been doing really well.
Compliment from Tristan, right. Few and far between.
In the RX
Ben Cosby, currently 14th.
Say that again.
Ben Cosby. What did I say?
No, I talked over you, sorry. Right.
Ben Cosby, 14th, 712 scaled, 20.3. Well done.
In the RX division, Ben Shave smashed it. He repeated it though and got 3 extra handstand push-ups. Do you think it was worth it?
And 11 deadlifts, it says.
Oh.
So that sounds like a worthy repeat. And Ben Fairley repeated and he got an extra 2 deadlifts at the heavy bar and a 5-foot handstand walk. That's awesome.
I don't know if that was worth it. He kind of collapsed.
Getting on the handstand walks, that's big. Good on him.
He was desperate to get them down.
So, 20.4, have fun.
Yeah, there's only one thing left to do. We have you, a cute doggy.
What do I do, open it and...
Just look hot, take your shirt off.
I don't want you to be no slave. I don't want you to work all day, but I want you to be true, and I just wanna make love to you. your clothes. I don't want to keep you indoors. There is nothing for you to do but keep me making love to you. Love to you.
Ooh. Oh, thanks.